Welcome to the bio support. In this video, we are going to discuss about levels of organization. Basically, we know a cell should have a common features like cytoplasm, nucleus, and cell membrane. Some cells have adapted themselves to perform specialized function. For example, ciliated cell, which is located in the trachea, bronchi, and oviducts. Adaptation of ciliated cell. These cells have adapted to have a structure called cilia from cytoplasm. And the cilia is thin, hair-like structure. Function of ciliated cell. Before going to learn about the ciliated cell, you should know about goblet cell. This goblet cell releases mucus. This mucus can trap the dust particles. So now you can see the mucus found over here. So cilia, which helps to move to and fro to remove the mucus. In oviduct also, you can find the ciliated cell, which helps the ovum to move towards the uterus for the implantation. Nerve cell adaptation. If you look at this picture, it's very clear the nerve cells are long. If you look at the normal cell, has cytoplasm, nucleus, and mitochondria the same way. Here, this cell is totally different from the normal cell. This cell is very long and it also branched. So what is the importance of this longness is that it can connect to different parts of the body of the central nervous system. And why it is branched is that to communicate with the other nerve cells or muscles and glands. If you look at the cytoplasm, is somewhat extended towards here. See, this extension we call this as axon. And if you look at this axon, you have this yellow sheath, you know, this myelin sheath, we call that as a fatty layer. This fatty layer acts as a insulator. So we say that this fatty sheath insulates the nerve cell and speeds up the nerve cell. This nerve cell is found in the nervous system. The function of this nerve cell is to conduct impulses. Red blood cell adaptation. Red blood cells are biconcave in shape, which increases the surface area for more efficient diffusion of oxygen. If you look at the cytoplasm of the red blood cell contains hemoglobin pigment. That's why the cytoplasm is red in color. And if you see the red blood cell, the nucleus is absent, which gives more space for the hemoglobin to capture oxygen. When it combines with oxygen, it will form oxyhemoglobin, and if it combines with carbon dioxide, it turns into carboxyhemoglobin. Usually, it is located in the blood. The function of the red blood cell is to transport oxygen. Sperm cell adaptation. In the sperm cell, there are three sections. They are head, midpiece, and tail. The head contains acrosome and a haploid nucleus. So nucleus contains 23 chromosomes. The acrosome is the layer where you can see digestive enzymes, which is used to penetrate an egg. The midpiece region contains mitochondria to release energy, which is needed to swim and fertilize the egg. The tail region, which helps or enables the sperm to swim. The location of the sperm cell is found in male reproductive system. The function of the sperm cell is for reproduction. Egg cell or ovum adaptation. The egg cell contains a lot of cytoplasm, which has nutrients for the growth of the early embryo. It also has haploid nucleus, contains the genetic material for fertilization. If you look at the cell membrane, The cell membrane changes after fertilization by a single sperm so that no more sperm can enter. For example, this cell membrane forms a cortisone layer so that the other sperms cannot enter, only one can enter. So this haploid nucleus is something like you can have 23 chromosomes. In a human, you have 46 chromosome, which is diploid state, and 23 is something we call it as haploid. This egg cell is found in the female reproductive system. The function of this egg cell is for reproduction. Let's see about the plant cell. Root hair cell. If you look at this cell adaptation, you can see that a normal cell has a finger-like projection which has a large vacuole. So this large vacuole is helpful to increase the surface area for maximum absorption of water and mineral ions. If you look at this plant cell, you can't find a chloroplast because it is found inside the soil. So that there is no need of chloroplast. It has some mitochondria for the active absorption of water and ions. Usually through active transport, the water or the ions which is present in the soil can be taken into the cell. So this root hair cell is found in the root, and the function of the root hair cell is to absorb water and mineral ions from the soil. Xylem micelle. The adaptation of the xylem micelle, if you look at this picture, you can see that it looks like a hollow pipe, like a structure. So this long thin hollow tube, which doesn't have an end wall, an uninterrupted flow of water goes in an unidirectional way. So that's why one way only. The xylem micelle only takes through one way. And usually these cells are dead. Why these cells are dead? Because there is a chemical called lignin. This lignin chemical will destroy all the organelles which is present inside the thing. So that what happened? There is a big hollow structure is formed. And this lignin chemical also helpful to support the plant. The function of this xylem micelle is to conduct water through the plants and support of the plant, which is located in the stem. Palisade mesophyll cell. If you look at this adaptation, the palisade mesophyll cell has a large surface area. It has lots of chloroplast. If you look at the picture of a leaf cell, you can see that this palisade mesophyll cells are tightly packed, and the cell wall and the other parts of the cytoplasm are transparent to let the light pass through the leaf. Why the cell wall and the other parts of the cytoplasm are transparent is because for the photosynthesis. So during the photosynthesis, what happened is that there's a glucose molecule has been synthesized. So where it is found? Usually it is found in the leaf. The function of the palisade mesophyll cell is for photosynthesis. Let's see about the levels of organization. If you see the chemicals like atoms and molecules which joins to form a cellular level, which is cell. So cell is a structural and functional and biological unit of all living organism. And this group of cells will join together to form a shared function is called it as tissue. So when this group of tissues working together to perform a specific function, we call it as organ. So you can see that a group of cell to form a tissue, a group of tissues like for example a smooth muscle tissue and epithelial tissue to form a organ. Okay, so when a group of organ with related function, for example, esophagus, liver, stomach and pancreas, these are all organs which is useful for the digestive system. So that's why we say that as a group of organs with related function working together to perform a body function, we call that as organ system. When group of organ system join together to form a organism. Let's try some questions. Which letter identifies a cell, a tissue and an organ? This is the internal structure of a leaf and this is the external structure of a leaf. And here you can see that the number 2 is, we call that this as a organ. And 3 and 4 are called as cell and this is a tissue. So we have to identify a cell, tissue and organ. So we have 2 types of cells. This is a palisade mesophyll cell and this is a spongy mesophyll cell. So whether it can be an A or a C. So if you look at this tissue, tissue is number 1. So we can easily identify the answer is C. So the next question, you try and identify which term describes the part of a plant. You just comment on it. If you like this video, click the like button and share it with your friends. Subscribe to my channel for more videos. Thank you.